Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your girl, Pastor Dre, called of the Change Church. Jumping online to hit you with another video. If you guys aren't following me on TikTok, I have no idea what y'all doing. Like, y'all really should be following me on TikTok. It is Thursday night. I am at Sweet Baby Jesus' house, and we're about to have Bible study tonight. But I wanted to jump online and tell you guys why my family is so concerned about me having another baby. Like I want to tell you, like, why my mom and them are so kind of like worried about me having another kid. So, let's just take it back. I had Papa when I was 18 years old, right before my 19th birthday is when I had Papa. Okay. I was unaware of postpartum, but to be 100% clear, I was scared, nervous, and did not want a baby. Yes, you heard that right. I didn't want a kid. I was out there giving my life to the devil, putting my best foot forward, living for Satan. And I was fine with it at the time. I was okay with it. But I find out that I'm pregnant. And so after I had Papa, I was saying I was on drugs is real. Like, that sounds real ugly, but it is the truth. I was out there. Let me just put it like that. I was way, way, way out there. I was not mother of the week, mother of the year. Just, was I a mother is a question. But anyway, so I was way out there. I wasn't ready to grow up. I wasn't ready to be a parent. I was a spoiled brat, actually. I went through a lot. But after I had Papa, his dad, who taught me how to cook a little bit, that's another story time. But Papa's dad and I was living together, and my younger sister, my younger god sister, Kiki, was living with us at that time, or staying over our house all the time, however you want to put it. And so he was taking her to school that morning. And normally I would take her to school, but he was taking her to school that morning. And when he got up, he's like, yo, I'm finna take Kiki to school right quick. I'm like, no. You don't get to take Kiki to school, because what am I going to do with this baby? Like, what am I going to do? And he ends up taking her to school. The second the door closed, it's almost like Papa was like, my daddy gone, and y'all left me here with this lady. And he's crying. I don't know what to do. No, like, not a little bit. I knew what to do a little bit. Like, no, I have no idea what to do. So I tried to give him a binky, a pacifier. He was completely against the binky. He's not for the binky. He spit it right back out and continued to cry. So I was like, that sucks. So then from that, I warmed him up a bottle, but the bottle was too freaking hot. And I would never forget that little tongue in his mouth after I'm trying to give it to him. It's scorching hot, y'all. Oh, my God. I can't believe I'm saying this. It was horrible. And his little tongue was like shaking uncontrollably in his mouth. I was like, freak. So I tried to, like, cool it down, give him, like, some cold milk. Again, it's not working. Because he already, like, you done burned me already, lady. Like, no, I'm not interested. So I changed his pamper because I'm thinking maybe his pamper needs to be changed. I sit him up there to change his pamper, and I forgot to put the little wee-wee down. Again, just turned 19. Papa's birthday is April 18th. My birthday is May 15th. So roughly 1 month after I had him, I turned 19 years old. So anyway, I try to change his pamper. The wee-wee stick up, so he pees all over me. Like, all over me. I'm trying this. I'm singing. Y'all know I can't sing, but I'm singing, I'm doing like my very best, and it's not working at all. So, what I ended up doing was I opened the door. The second I opened the door, he stopped crying. I said, I think I'm on to something here. I'm on to something here. So I closed the door. He started crying again. I said, bruh, I figured it out. I got it. Opened the door. He stopped crying. I know what's up. I know what's up. So I put him in his car seat, strapped him in there, opened up the front door. Put my baby in his car seat on the front porch. Hey, I thought this was the No Judging channel. Get it together. I put my baby on the front porch. Again, I'm 19, y'all. And I put my baby on the front porch. And I turned the sofa around so I could watch him and the TV while he was on the front porch. So his dad comes home. And he is livid. Jackie, what is wrong with you? You have lost your mind. He's calling my mom. He's just doing the most. And I'm like, no, your baby was crying. And I stopped your baby from crying. Like, your baby was crying. He was like, yeah, cut it out. And so, because I felt so bad, coupled with the other things that were going on in my life, I really like rejected being a parent. Like, whoever wanted to babysit my baby, babysat my baby. Whoever, like, I mean, so many people had my baby, like from the Killingsworths to the Johnsons, my sisters, my mother and my stepfather, my grandmother had my baby for a very long time. It was just like his dad and his dad's people, like his dad's uncles, his dad's aunties, his dad's sister, his dad's grandmother. Like, my baby was all over the place, okay? Some things happened that caused me to really wake up and snap up and become a mother. But at that time, I was not the best mother. So I have went years saying like I'm not having no other baby. And you seen the other video when I didn't talk about the abortions, but I mentioned the abortions. And so I just made it up in my mind that yeah, I'm not having no more kids. Like never, ever. Ever having any more kids. And to top it off, Papa was like bad as hell from birth, clean up until he was about 11, 10 or 11. And I mean bad as hell. I mean the worst. When I tell the story about him punching a teacher in the breast, he's like, no, that's not quite what happened. That's not what happened. So I won't tell y'all that story just yet. But just know, yeah, he was bad. Okay, so I was like, yeah, I'm not going through that again. He is now 15, and here I am pregnant again. But what's really super neat, and I'm about to go, but what's really super neat is that Papa's birthday is April 18th, and this baby due date is April the 14th. I felt like that was so super cute. And I'm glad that I've waited this long, even though Papa like, I'm not babysitting your baby. I'm not holding your baby. I'm not messing with your baby. Papa's very adamant about that. So yeah, he's very like, no, I'm not with that. So that is the reason why my family is quote unquote worried. But I'm letting them know I'm old now. Like I done had your baby. I done babysat your baby. I keep your bad baby. I mean, and all the kids love TT. Like swear. So that's kind of where I'm at with it. Y'all let me know if y'all had any mother bloopers, you know, as your when your kid was a baby in the comment section. I need to know if y'all had any bloopers. Cause I know I can't be the only one. I can't be the only one.